the bodies are continuing to move as you come down to the catch. Now, if I go for a slower piece of film, it's probably more obvious. And you all do it to different extents. You look at... See, our hands, our elbows are still bent, and we're starting to come down the slide. And our bodies continue to go over as we're coming into the front. Now, you'll find that we get a better, easier catch if you can get yourself set up for the catch a little bit earlier. And so you want to sit at the finish, hands away, and I don't want it robotic like hands away, body over. It's got to be smooth. You make it a smooth motion. But it's really about getting the hands away, getting the body over before, when you're about halfway down the slide, or thereabouts, then you should be ready for the catch. So your arms should be fully extended, and not in your sockets, like I explained a minute, so fully extended, your body over and ready to take the catch. And then you hold it there as you come into the front. A few reasons why that's important, particularly with younger crews, is that when you're coming into the catch, if your body's still moving as you're coming into the catch, then there's a tendency to overreach and to go too far, and then not get a good catch because you're not in a strong position because your body's too curved over. And so that's a real danger with getting it that way. The other thing is, if you can get your body over and in the right position, then when you pull yourself down into the front, then it's going to be a conscious, I'm pulling myself down the slide movement, which is going to give you better acceleration in the boat in that recovery phase, rather than just sort of having it all happen all at once. But we'll all merge together. So maybe if we set up a couple of ergos, and we'll put everyone through an ergo from posture. And so if we can get the posture right, then when you go out there to take the catch and get the catch right, then it's going to be really easy because you're going to be ready for that catch well before you get there. And so when you get there, we've got to, right, now all I've got to do is just put the blade in, and then I've got to push. That sequence is so important. In, then push, not pushing in or anything like that. The other thing about how far you should reach, if I've got my arms straight there, I'm reaching as far as I can. Or am I? Because I can go to there, I can bring it back to here. Now if I've got my shoulder locked back hard like that, then I'm going to have a tense shoulder. If I've got a tense shoulder, then I'm going to have a tense grip. And so you want to have it really relaxed. So if everyone can put their hand out in front of them like that for me. I want you to clench your fist really, really tight. Really tight. Now relax your shoulder at the same time. You can't do it. This doesn't work. And so you want to have relaxed shoulders at the catch, because we don't want to use our shoulder, all these small muscles up here, we don't want to use them to hold the blade because they're not very good at that. They don't hold enough glycogen stores, not enough energy in them to actually do a lot of work. And whereas if you do a chin-up, for example, and you're hanging from a bar, you can hang there for a long time if you just relax and just hang there, because these muscles aren't doing anything. What you're doing is you're using your bones and your tendons to hold. So in a boat, you want to use those, because that doesn't use any energy. So you want to use your bones and tendons to hold. If you're holding your shoulder back here, that's not going to work. If you've got tense grip, everything's going to be tense. So we're going to have tense shoulders.